Wendy Williams, who has been keeping a secret about her health. So what's going on?
Well, I suffer from hyperhidrosis, which is, you know, a problem perspiring. For me, it's under my arms. And it's weird, Dr. Oz. I only perspire like crazy when I'm doing the talk show. In regular life, I don't perspire. I do Pilates, I'm fine. I don't perspire on my forehead. It's under my arms during the show. And as we know, fabrics collect the moisture, and it's just not hot. And I have had prescription deodorant. And please, people tell me about all the various deodorants and the clinical secrets and things like that. I've done it all, and I've even done the Botox not. So, am I alone?
No, you're not alone. In fact, you've got good company right here on the set, because I got the exact same issue.
What do you do?
I've tried everything. I've had these little bras, the male bras they put under my arms to try to suck up the moisture. It doesn't work. I wear blazers now.
I go right through that. They put those pads underneath.
But you have one big advantage over me.
What's
You have this nice, that hair comes down and covers up your armpits.
I have to tell you something, but, you know, and it's no secret, I do wear wigs. I have thyroid disease. But I do wear longer hair when I know that it's a fabric that's going to really expose. However, I am ready to take the bull by the horns.
All right. There's an FDA-approved treatment for underarm sweat that I have been looking at personally.
Tell me.
I'm going to share it with you. It's a non-invasive procedure. It's called miraDry.
I know all about it.
You do.
Teach me.
I'll sit back here.
Okay, I can tell you. All right, here's what miraDry is. No lie, I just finished researching, and this is what I'm going to get done. First of all, unlike Botox under the arms, miraDry is permanent. What the dermatologist does, or you can go to a regular doctor, is they do a little zapping. They numb under your arms. They do a little zapping. You can go right back to work, but there will be some discomfort and a little bit of swelling. But like I always say, no pain, no gain. and you go one time. You're in the office for an hour. Then you go back to work. And 3 months later, you go back if you want to get the rest of it done. And again, it's permanent. And I think that might be for me and you.
Well, you know what? Let's do it together. But I'm going to go back and just show you a quick animation so everyone's on the same page with us. I'm going to look at the machine.
Okay.
Okay, come back here.
Now, this is brand new, right, Oz?
It's brand new. It's FDA approved, though.
Yes.
So here's what happens, basically. So here you are, lying down the table. And if you look at, of course, on the underarm area, you've got sweat pores coming out. And that's because you've got lots of sweat glands down there. And the sweat glands are deep under the skin. That's what that miraDry device looks like when it goes on the skin. But let's turn it around, look inside the skin to see what's going on. That's where the action is. So what ends up happening is you put this device on top. The miraDry, and it puts those microwave-like waves that come down, and they actually begin to heat up the tissue. And of course, they would burn the skin normally, so instead, they keep the device cold. That cools down the area just beneath the skin, but it allows the heat to penetrate deeply where the sweat glands are and knocks them off, which is why, in theory, it's permanent. In theory.
In theory.
That's what the goal is.
But you know what? As far as I'm concerned, Oz, if me and you could lose 80% of our perspiration, we are winning.
In the other arm area?
Yes, yes.
So let's go look what the device is so everyone knows what it actually might feel like.
Oh, good.
So this is the actual device. A doctor would take this. Come on over to that right this side, and I'll practice on you.
Okay.
That's why it's called practicing medicine.
Okay.
The device looks like this. So you lift your arm up, and you put it right there, and you push it in. I'm not going to turn it on. When you push it in like this, of course, you'd use anesthesia normally.
Yes.
Which is what I'm going to have to do on the set right now.
Right.
But after you put a little bit of stuff in there, you zap, 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 zap. And this device, you have to hold it there for a little while. It takes about an hour for the procedure.
Now, I saw a variety of prices with it, but in general, people were saying it's less expensive than Botox, and Botox only lasts about 3 months, and then you have to go back and get it done.
I think this is a smarter tap to take. This costs about $1,000 for procedures. And depending on how much money you have, it might be a reasonable thought for some folks. Again, there's no harm from sweating under your arms. It's a little awkward. It's a little bit of a pain in the neck, but you know, it's not mandatory people have it. But if you're going to get it, it's going to cost that much. You might have to do it more than once.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Oh, I'll get back to you. I'm in.
Can I help do it to you?
No. I need to sit down with flat shoes.
All right, coming up, more new health trends with Wendy. Find out what's hot and what's not. Plus, she's a gift for everybody here. Find out what it is. That is next. The long